Over 40,000 students attend the Queensland University of Technology, and daily they must formulate a plan to get to uni on time. A combination of public transport and transportation within a private vehicle often occurs, but which is often the quicker, ultimately cheaper, and most popular option? Today we're going to identify what the general opinion is. Hi Tamika, how are you today?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
Very well, thank you. So today we're just going to have a quick chat about how you got to uni.
Okay.
Lovely. So how did you get to uni today?
Today I actually caught the train from Burpengary Station to Roma Street and then caught the bus from Roma Street to Kelvin Grove.
Wow, so a bit of a long trip?
Yeah, I got on the train about 6:30 and didn't get here till 8.
Public transport is one of the many options available for the modern day QUT student, with QUT being located on several bus lines. These public transport options are utilised due to their reliable nature and convenience, not to mention their seemingly cheap prices. In order to gain the full public transport experience, be sure to grab a go card. These cards only add to the convenience within public transport. So is public transport or driving to uni the most popular for students? Today we asked a few the same question. So how did you get to university today?
I caught the train. I drove to Garden City and then I bused it to the Mater and then to uni.
Train.
How much did that cost you?
$3.50.
Like $2, I think.
I think it costs about like $5 a day.
$1.50 for the fare.
On my go-kart, like $2.90 something. Maybe about $3.
$5 something.
Yeah, so do you drive to uni or?
Yeah, sometimes I do. It's a little bit quicker to drive to uni.
Would you say perhaps that might be more expensive, like including things like rego and whatnot?
Yeah, definitely, because driving cost me at least $4 to $6 in parking alone, it's definitely the more expensive option.
So with the parking, did you find that you ran into a few issues?
Yeah, I have to get to university at least 7:30 to get a park. Normally all the parks are gone by 9 o'clock and I'm always really worried that I won't get a park.
Another popular transportation option available is to travel to university in a private vehicle. Driving to university and parking on campus is considered a much more reliable form of transport. There is often a reduced travel time as this form is to and from uni. Despite these elements, the cost of driving to and from uni can be deemed significantly higher. This is due to various elements, such as petrol, parking, registration and insurance, contributing to the daily cost. In addition to this fact, driving to QUT Kelvin Grove can be quite difficult, with limited number of car parks available after 9 a.m. due to the amount of students opting to drive to uni. I see. So in the end, what do you prefer, public transport or driving?
I probably prefer public transport just because it's easier and also cheaper.
So as you can see, there are a variety of options available for the students travelling to and from the Queensland University of Technology. The public transport options available are convenient, easily accessible and relatively cheap transportation options. In comparison, whilst driving in a private vehicle is considered a much more reliable form of transport, it is often associated with a higher price tag. There are positives and negatives to both forms of transport options presented here today. And, unfortunately, there is no definite answer as to which one is better. It all depends on which elements you are looking for.